when they're retired.
What's up, everybody? I just stopped by our Lawrenceville office space here. They're going over some campaigns. I thought I would pop it on live and see if you can say. I'm putting them on the spot here, if I can flip it around. Say, what's up, Smiak, Megan? So we're going to go over, just kind of show you a little bit about what's going on, what we're talking about in this specific scenario. We're going to be talking about a new campaign that we're running. So if you have any questions, obviously pop on, ask them. But I'm going to try to get this thing right here. Awesome.
Yes. So, 62 plus, at least one person in the home, retired, probably have grandkids, maybe interested in the vacation home. I don't think gender matters, so we're gender neutral here, you target male and female. And for this type of purchase, I think, so for that audience, those people, when we talk about platforms, right? Less of an Instagram audience, more of a Facebook.
Yeah, I already pulled up some research, and they're highly penetrated. Facebook, LinkedIn is another big one, apparently.
Especially if they're, you know, maybe recently retired or thinking about retiring.
But a lot.
So you're saying LinkedIn might be a good platform for this type of product for 62?
For the age group.
And do you think it's going to be the kids? Is that what you mentioned?
No, I think it's going to be the person 62 plus, but they likely are retiring or thinking of retiring, have grandkids, and are looking to get like a home closer to the grandkids or get a second home as a vacation home, and it's really a gender neutral product. So if we can find them, Facebook, we know it's heavy on the 62 plus audience.
Do you think the grant or the kids are going to help them come up with this idea of doing this?
I don't know.
So should that be our target?
I think it's probably to first target them. I think it's probably going to be targeting the person who would actually do the purchase as your primary audience, but you may have a secondary campaign for the children of these 60 plus, you know, they're in their 30s or 40s, maybe helping their parents.
So test both of them.
Yeah. So.
So essentially, we've been working with this client for what, 7 months now?
Mm-hmm. Something like that.
And they have different campaigns.
To different audiences.
To different audiences, depending upon what they want to focus on. They reach out to us and say, hey, we want to start focusing on this product.
Yep.
And then and that's what we're doing right now, is putting the campaign together.
Yeah, so then they rely on us to take that product. They usually do a great job at generating some video content, some brochures, that type of stuff, so that we can understand the product. We take that and then figure out who the target audience is, what platform we need to be on, and then put together and figure out, I mean, some of the things we've done for them are through Facebook lead ads, some of it are through Messenger bots, so it's just depending on who we're trying to reach. So what we're trying to figure out right now, this is a slightly different audience from who we normally target for them, so seeing if we need to be trying something new.
And very big for this client is quality over quantity whenever it comes to leads and opportunities.
Yes, so this is definitely, this is
so we got to keep that in mind.
So Facebook, LinkedIn, and also, let's see how maybe put this, let's do some keyword research. into how people are searching for this product on Google.
LinkedIn is, that's interesting to me.
I think the idea is after retirement, they start thinking about starting their own business most of the time, and that's why they're on LinkedIn.
They might be thinking about doing that.
Yeah. And 19% of...
It's worth a shot. I mean, it's worth testing.
Yeah. And 19% of this audience is, they seem more likely to share content. So I know LinkedIn currently is...
Look at me.
She started 2 weeks ago. We're super excited.
I think another one might be YouTube. They, with the...
I like YouTube. Yeah.
Yeah, with the content that they share, more than likely they want it to be visual. And YouTube is the preferred video website for this age group.
And what we're probably going to want to do with this, I like this because you guys have Facebook, which is kind of a platform. Google and YouTube are together. LinkedIn is separate. If you drive all of these to what we're probably going to want to do for this, because it's a little different from what we've done in the past, is a separate sales page. You know, how video.
And can you hear us okay?
Content.
If you put on there, I see they're on there. I just want to make sure they can.
Oh, okay. Video content, talking about form fills, running this is probably like more of a conversion campaign versus a lead ad, and we really want to get that high quality. Run all of this to the same sales page with retargeting pixels. And then basically, if they visit it from Facebook, we're going to retarget on there. If they watch a video on YouTube, you can retarget them through like GDN. Same thing for Google. So you make it more of a full campaign versus just focusing on like a single platform, which has worked really well in some other instances. But I think with this one, and they really want to like cover the market with this new product, so hitting a few different ones, all driving to a sales page that's designed just for this product versus the website.
Makes sense?
Yes. So the next thing that we have to do is basically go and take this target audience and create what that looks like on each of these different platforms and then do our keyword research from the
perspective. And obviously we've got to take into account what the budget is for this. So
what we'll typically do is we know what this client's budget is roughly, but if we have a suggestion, I'm like, hey, we really think we can cover the marketplace, get good results by putting a little bit towards each of this, we'll go back with a recommendation for them to react to.
Oh.
So, yeah.
Awesome.
So that's just very high level, but that's where we start, and then we then take basically our team and assign different roles to everybody to do their part, and then we are presenting this to the client on Wednesday.
Yeah. And then go live with it. And we're currently running, what, 3 or 4 other campaigns right now?
Yeah, we've got 3 other products running for them right now, so this will be a 4th one.
Yeah. And the ultimate goal with all of this is to generate more calls and appointments.
For them, generally, we take them, they fill out a form to get their information, but they also have a link to actually schedule a 15-minute call or through their calendar. So their representatives will reach out with them directly, but they also have the opportunity to go ahead and schedule a call if they're highly interested in that product. And our biggest thing is we know the things that they have to like qualify for to be a good lead. So we will try to collect as much of that information here at the form fill and lot level so that we can provide the client with all of that information ahead of time. So when they go into the actual call or appointment or meeting, they've got a list of kind of where they stand on qualifications. So they kind of know what they're going into at the meeting.
So real quick, can you map out almost what that funnel would look like?
Yes, I can.
I mean, you can just either do it up there. Or...
Well, I can't reach all the way up there. Basically, what you would do for something like this, if you think about it, you may have like a top of funnel Facebook ad. So here's your top of funnel Facebook ad. That's going to go, here's our sales landing page. they go here and they fill it out, but or they fill it out, they're coming with you. If they don't, they circle back to your bottom funnel, another Facebook ad reminding them, hey, we know you're interested, see if you qualify, schedule a call with our team today, back to the landing page where we try to make them a lead. At the same time, we'll come back to LinkedIn, because that's a little bit of a different one. You've got Google, these are people actively searching for what you have to offer. So they're typing something into the Google search bar, we show up, hopefully in that 1, 2, or 3 ad space, take them to the landing page. If they do not, they either become a lead, or if they do not convert, we use GDN to send them some retargeting ads that also go back to the landing page. At the same time, sorry, I'm not much of an artist, but you get the idea. At the same time, you've got videos, because this client has video content, running on YouTube. Now, we use this less as a straight conversion metric. You know, it's more of awareness, educating about the product. But if someone then views a certain portion of this video, they will also be retargeted with this GDM creative that goes back to the landing page. So it's basically a cycle that the landing page didn't become a lead, but if they hit the landing page and they don't become a lead, we make sure to retarget them on whatever platform they're on. But in this scenario, whether they're people who are mostly on Facebook, doing an active search, whether they're on YouTube, you're going to cover them no matter which platform they go to. And the whole idea, this is where the whole retargeting piece is where so many people miss it, because it is highly unlikely that somebody's going to see something for the first time and go ahead and enter all their information and schedule a call. So that's why we have to stay back in front of them. And for a product like this, especially when this is a little bit of a new market, slightly older audience than what we've done for the other ones, testing out the different platforms to start with. Now let's say 30, 60 days into it, we realize we're getting our highest quality leads from Facebook. We can then shift some of that money from Google or YouTube up into Facebook. But at this point, we don't know, so you've got to use that first 30, 60 days to test and see where you're getting the better traffic from. So is that the funnel you wanted?
Yeah, I mean, ultimately, what are we typically looking at whenever we start a campaign like this to know it's got the makings of being a successful campaign?
Well, we know what the convert, like the click-through rates we need to look for. They're different on Facebook versus Google versus YouTube. You know, we want to make sure that people are watching a certain amount of the video, with 30, you know, view-through rate of 30% plus. Facebook top of funnel at 1% plus, bottom of funnel at 4% plus. So if we see those like soft stats to start with, we'll know if it has the potential to be successful. And then over time, what we're doing in that first 30, 60 days is figuring out how much do we have to pay for a quality lead. Because these have basically a high value, you know, if they were to close the deal. So figuring out, you know, do we have to pay $15 for a high quality lead? Do we pay $5 for a high quality lead? Do we pay $30 for a high quality lead? Figure out what the lead cost is for each of the different platforms. So then 60 days and beyond, you're optimizing for lower cost for higher quality.
Do we have a benchmark for what the landing page or the sales page needs to convert at?
It depends. Probably, you know, for cold traffic, we usually look at like, you know, 3-4%.
Yeah.
So that's what we'll take, but the first 30 to 60 days are really going to be building, figuring out what we need to pay.
Jeez, switch.
Oh, you darn.
We're throwing stuff.
What we need to pay for a quality lead, figuring out what combination is giving us the lowest cost and higher quality, and then you take that at 60 days and you scale. Plus, the nice thing about this is that this client is actually local to us, here in Georgia, but they can offer this product throughout the Southeast. But typically what we do is we start in Georgia, we've done this with other products, and then once we find the right formula, we expand it to other states.
Yep.
So that's so you get that right in that first 30, 60 days, and then you can expand it.
Absolutely.
So that's it.
Yep. Yeah, and the retargeting and all of this, obviously, from the landing page is going to be the key, because a lot of people are going to come to this and leave without doing anything.
Right, and see, because the problem is, especially for something like this, is it's going to take research. They'll come to the landing page, but we're all distracted. I mean, they may be sitting in a doctor's office and see it, you know, but don't have time to really look into it. The problem is, after they leave, they might not remember who the company was that's offering it. So what are they going to do next? They're going to go Google it.
Yeah.
Because they remember, oh yeah, I'm interested in that, but I don't remember who it was. They Google it, but we want to make sure that we are one of the first ones they see there. And then also, next time they get on Facebook or, you know, through the Google Display Network, that they see that again and are reminded, like, yeah, that's the product that I was looking at earlier. So, because that's why conversion rates are so much lower top funnel, because it's less likely, especially for a product like this, because this is an impulse buy. This is something that's going to take research. You've got to stay with the product.
And the program that they're in, we're going to recreate this. The landing page, the ads.
Yeah, we create all of this.
Yeah, and they normally have content already.
Yeah, and we take their content and they, you know, create some other stuff. And they usually do a good job with videos and stuff. But we take it and build a landing page for them.
Landing pages are like the item from the store that you didn't think you needed, so you didn't buy, but you don't stop thinking about them, and then you can't find them until an ad appears for the same thing.
Absolutely. Yep, totally. So we have to.
I like that.
Yeah. So we have to create a highly converting landing page, which, just like you said, the retargeting is where it's at to make sure that we keep that back in front of them.
Well, yeah, I mean, the retargeting obviously is where the ROI really comes in, right?
Mm-hmm.
So.
Yeah, if we break even top of funnel, I consider that a success. Like, if we, you know, don't lose money, but we don't make money top of funnel, that's great. Where you're looking to get your return, bottom of funnel, and the retargeting. So that's why a lot of people say that Facebook ads aren't successful, right? They run one ad, they say they spent $200 and didn't get anything, or they broke even, which I'd be like, actually, that's really good if you weren't retargeting anybody. So that's not having that full funnel set up is why people think Facebook ads don't work.
Yeah. So for us to map all this out for just one campaign, which one, what do they own? Like our business builder type?
Yes, they're on the business builder.
We need to charge more. But anyway.
All right.
Well, keep doing it. Hopefully that helps. Obviously, we just wanted to show a little bit behind the scenes of what's going on. Everybody say bye.
Bye.
It's me, Aunt. Say bye. And you guys keep kicking ass.